Hi everyone, welcome to the season finale of NEAS. I'm the greatest cold open master in the history of the world, main man Murky, head of the Murky's Minions, and I outdid myself for the finale, folks. That's right, I got a couple of celebrity guests to do the cold open, and they're big fans of the channel and close personal friends of mine as well. And I know you may have read some news articles about a fraud that involved a young baby, somebody pretending a baby was dying in order to do fraud. That is unrelated. That is unrelated to this. These guys did it because they love the channel and they wanted to. Nothing to do with a baby.
Hi, baby Bruce. This is Ike Barinholtz from various stuff. I heard you're not doing well and you're in the hospital, and we're thinking about you. And I have a message for you. This is NEAS. Let's start the show. So get well soon, baby Bruce.
Hey, Bruce. How you doing, little buddy? Somebody told me you're feeling a little under the weather. Okay. And this person also told me that they care about you very much and that you're going to pull through and that you should stay strong. Oh, and this person also told me to tell you that you might like to hear these words. This is NEAS. Now let's start the show.
Forget everything that you think you know, 'cause NEAS is now a show. We got the pranks, yeah, we got the pranks, yeah. No need for angst, yeah, we got the pranks, yeah. We got the pranks, yeah, we got the pranks, yeah. No need for thanks, yeah, we got the pranks, yeah. Bruce and the Prankstars trolling on the phone.
Chris One. Yoo-hoo, everybody. It's me, your host, Chris One, and this is the season finale of NEAS The Show. Today, I'm joined by a co-host, One Take Jake. And now you go. Oh, sorry. Hi, I'm One Take Jake, and I am my own man. Fantastic. And we don't have anything planned. We just kind of thought that it would be cool to see us both on screen at the same time. But maybe we should have thought of something to do, considering as it is the season finale. But anyways, we're out of time. Let's head over to the desk. All right, everyone, over at the desk for the final time. And if I could be real with you for a second, I will say I'm really happy to never do this again. Filming these, it's really the low point of my week. But I should check in with my old co-host, Chris, too, just to make sure all of his issues have been resolved for the season and everything's been wrapped up into a neat little package.
Yeah, that's right. Everything's good.
Oh, that's great to hear. Let's move on to the episode, and it's a fantastic season finale for you folks, as we've got a snap-off between Ed Till and J.J. McCartney. We've got the Prankstars going after Rudy Giuliani. Prank Stallone makes calls to Chris Cuomo, Grant Stinchfield, and Larry Elder. Plus, another episode of The Worst of Us, and Butch calls last week's guest on The Worst of Us, Jim Fetzer. First things first, though, one thing we've never done on the channel is go on location. That's what we decided to do for the season finale, as we sent our correspondent Daryl Kraft out to a real anti-vaccine, anti-mask rally in Vancouver. Check it out.
All right, here I go on my way to the big rally. Talk about how we're losing our freedom here in this country. And I really hope I don't run into anybody that I know. Hello, everyone. How are you? I'm a conservative stand-up comedian. I'm doing a live stream here on my YouTube. I want to talk about free speech and how we're losing our freedom here in this country. Do you agree with that? Sorry?
For sure. Yes.
You want to be? Do you agree we're losing our freedom?
Definitely. Yes.
And Have you heard about how open mics aren't open mics anymore? Have you heard about that?
It's kind of hard. A lot of them aren't as open as you like them to be.
Well, they say it's an open mic, but then you show up and they say, well, you can't perform there. Well, that's not an open mic. That's not freedom at all. Yeah. Thank you for your time. I appreciate it.
Thanks for what you're doing.
Thank you.
Hi, Walter. Nice
to meet
you.
Oh, hey, Walter. How are you? I'm a conservative stand-up comedian, actually. My name's Daryl.
Hi, Daryl.
And I'm all about free speech. Where are you going, Walter? Walter doesn't want to be on camera? Walter! Walter! You don't want to be on cam? How come? Where's Walter going? Hey, how's it going? People's Party of Canada. I'm voting People's Party of Canada. I'm a free speech advocate.
A lot of people.
Absolutely. 5% of the population.
Well, I think it's way more than that.
I think it's about 5% at the moment, but I think it is going to get higher, definitely. But we can all agree free speech, stand-up comedy is under assault as well. Free speech. Absolutely. Thank you so much. Would anybody like to hear some stand-up comedy? Would anyone like to hear some free speech stand-up comedy? I am a conservative stand-up comedian. Who would like to hear me do my stand-up? Come on, everybody. Who wants to hear some comedy? Hey, how are you? I'm a conservative stand-up comedian. My name's Daryl Kraft. Thank you so much. I'm going to do some stand-up in a little bit for everybody. How are you? Where's the organizer? Who's in charge of this thing? Oh, they're over there. I just want to see if I can get up on the mic for a little bit, do a little bit of my stand-up.
Those two girls up there are in charge.
They're in charge?
Black and white.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it. All right, is your leg okay, sir? You have an owie on the leg? How did you get that, sir? Freedom? Was it in regards to free speech and freedom?
Doesn't have anything to do with this, that's for sure.
Okay, cool. Thank you. Thank you so much. This is fun, man. It's fun to be with all the patriots. Hey, how are you? I'm a stand-up comedian. I'm just doing a live stream, just recording for my YouTube. I do stand-up comedy, conservative stand-up comedy. So I'm just here doing... Who's the organizer? Is there any way... Like, I was hoping to maybe do some of my material on mic.
No, I don't think that will happen.
I can't do that?
I don't think that will happen.
Is that a free speech issue, maybe, or no?
No, that's not a free speech issue. That's yeah. This is organized for
They've already pre-done it. Do you mind being? I don't want to record you if you don't want to be on camera either. Okay, cool. Yeah, so you're saying they've already booked the show? They've already booked the show?
It's structured because this isn't just like.
It's not like an open mic.
No, this is about the nurses.
So I can't get on the mic. They're telling me I can't get on the mic, so I guess it's not an open mic after all, but that's cool. How you guys doing? I'm a conservative stand-up comedian. I'm here on behalf of conservative stand-up comedians talking about free speech. And I do have an issue. They won't let me get up on the microphone to do my jokes. And
I think they have an idea for like a silent protest or something.
Yeah. But silence doesn't get us very far.
Well, you know.
That's, you know. Could I do a joke or two for you guys? Just one?
Sure.
Okay, here we go. Okay, I want to get your reaction to it too. All right.
Test the audience.
No, hey, they told me the other day they got these vaccine mandates. I said, no thanks, I don't swing that way. Well, mandate being a date with another man.
Yeah,
thank you very much, guys. You guys have a good day. How's everybody doing? You guys like to laugh? Who likes to laugh? No, it says censored on it. You understand? It's making a political statement. Open mics should be open mics. If you show up at an open mic, you should get booked. It doesn't matter if they call it an open mic, they have to book you on the show. It's about freedom of open mics.
I feel that the scientific literature is being suppressed.
See, and here's your accent's from Britain.
Right.
Very cool. I'd love to go over there sometime and do some shows.
Hopefully, we'll be free to do so.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'd love to go over there. Do you have any contacts? Anybody that books a room or books any sort of comedy shows or anything like that? Oh, did you want to get a picture of me by any chance? I'm sort of into free speech and stuff. Just got my picture taken. Basically, I got a headshot done, basically, which was fucking cool to get a headshot, free headshot. Just got a free headshot. Did not expect to get a free headshot today, but I got one. Excellent. Yeah, we're smart! Yeah! 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 Free speech! Hello, ma'am. You're quite old. Hey, free speech! All right. Yeah! Why aren't we singing? Why aren't we singing? Oh, I want to be free! Oh, I want to be free! What's going on here, guys? A little enthusiasm here, yeah? Good Lord, a little enthusiasm. Why aren't we singing? What the heck? What's going on?
Ironic wearing a shirt that totes freedom when you're wearing a muzzle.
Oh, hey man, you're a little bit late, but what does your sign say?
Media, please do your job, not the CDC or WHO's trusted news.
It's a really long sign. It's too much. Is that why you're late? Because you had to write out all the stuff on the sign? You're here now. That's all that matters. See you guys later. Keep up the fight. See you later, buddy.
Frank Stallone is my personal favorite prankster on the channel because he's me. I'm him. He's me. And I like myself. This week for the season finale, I decided to outdo myself with calls to Grant Stinchfield from Newsmax and Chris Cuomo from CNN. I also called Larry Elder, who didn't answer, but I did leave him a message about the election. Check it out.
You guessed it.
Frank Stallone is on the phone.
Hello?
Hey, Chris, do you think there are still people who identify as homosexuals?
Come on, brother. You can do better than this.
Well, I'm asking you, do you remember the T-shirts and everything?
This is Grant.
Hey, Grant. JJ Shirts calling. How are you today?
Who's JJ Shirts?
Oh, I'm calling because we're actually working on a list right now, a short list for Journalist of the Year, your name, I guess, is on the list, so I'm meant to be reaching out on behalf of my publication to see if people would be interested in being included in such a list.
What's your publication?
It's called Dipshit Magazine.
Congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation.
Good one, bro. It's funny.
Hi, this is Larry. Leave a message.
At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Larry got trounced. What happened?
Ed Till and J.J. McCartney are famous for being huge snap jobs, snapping like nobody's ever snapped before at the smallest thing. You can call and say one word to either of them and they'll snap for 5 minutes. So we decided we'd have a little snap off to see who the ultimate snap champion of NEAS is. Check it out.
And in California, the biggest, by population, the biggest state in the union. Why would we trust that? Area code 304, what's your name and where are you calling from?
Hi, JJ, it's British Bobby. I'm in West Virginia.
You're in West Virginia. Okay, British Bobby, what's going on?
West Virginia by way of Manchester, I should say, by way of Edinburgh as well. So that's, but I'm in West Virginia now, being about 3 years or so I've lived in the United States of America.
Okay, well, welcome to the U.S. of A.
Well, thank you. I just wanted to say a nice shirt. It's the finale. Nice my shirt. It's the finale. J.J. McCartney Show.
All right. Area code 210. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hey, this is French Philip.
the retards are out. Somebody let the retards out. Yeah, everybody just take note. 343-055-2202. What?
Are there any normal people left in the world? And seriously, you know, one of the things that the Islamic terrorists were planning on doing, and of course did on 9/11, was hijack airliners and fly them into buildings. The one thing we will not let these creeps do is hijack our show. Simply not going to allow that to happen. So, but where are the normal people? Where are the normal people? That's what I want to know. Where are the normal people? Are there any left?
KK Snap!
We got Mike on the line. Mike is calling from Orlando. Hey, Mike, thanks a lot for jumping in today. How are you?
Hey, Ed. How are you doing?
Good. Very good. Good to hear from you.
Good, good. So I was curious, calling in, if you ever do fight Roy, would you take
your... I knew it. I saw it coming, didn't you? That's okay. That's all right. Listen, there is a remarkable dedication to this show. I don't know how it got started, actually. It's like all great love affairs, right? Who knows who made the first move? I don't know. But once Roy locked eyes on his radio dial, I'm sure, looking at that dial, staring at it, going, this guy, Till, I'm not going to have it. This guy is not coming on every day. I will not tolerate it.
Everything's fine with Ed Till.
And I say, you know, use all the bluster and conflict that you can, because you know, deep down, you need this show real bad. You need it. I, like you, I was lost once. Once I was wandering planet Earth, not knowing for sure what things were, not knowing for sure who I was, not making sense of the complex world of human emotion and catastrophic nature at the same time. Wow, how do you make... Well, you find something in the storm, in the wind, in the maelstrom. It's in there. You find it, and you don't know if it's any damn good. What do I know about this guy, Ed Till? He's nuts. He's crazy. But I'll tell you one thing. He's right there.
Everything's fine with Ed Till.
He's in the center of the whole problem. Just take a look at that thing. The entire difficulty is spelled Ed Till. So, one thing I must do. My name is Roy, damn it. Write it down. R-O-Y. Capital R. No last name necessary, just like Madonna and Cher. Woo! 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 It's a lot of burden, Roy. I feel it with you, but I'm in it for the long haul, my friend. I am in this not for now, not for an hour from now, but where does it ultimately lead? What is the final destination, Roy? You don't know. I don't know. That's what brings us together, as opposite as we are, as cataclysmically opposed to one another as we could be. Explosive. You would have to define the relationship, Roy, as explosive.
Everything's fine with Ed Till.
You know, that means it's probably glowing in the dark a little. That means there's probably an involuntary pull yen, yeah, something in there, right? Who knows? Maybe in the Eastern philosophy, it would be easier to understand. That's not our job. Roy, you and I are not here to explain what's going on. We are here to live and be whatever and wherever it takes us.
Everything's fine with Ed till he goes and snaps on you.
The prankster's favorite target is definitely Rudy Giuliani, and their favorite calls to make are ones about him marrying and having sex with his cousin. This week, though, we called about a different thing, his alcoholism, and he decided to lead us right into a cousin prank anyways. So what do you know? Check it out.
You don't want him to pull your card, because the pranksters, they prank hard.
So let's get to our callers on the Tunnel to Towers Foundation hotline on 77 WABC. Sergio in Newark, New Jersey.
Rudy, I love you.
Oh, well, that's nice, Sergio. So tell me about tell me why you're calling, Sergio. What's going on?
Well, Mr. Giuliani,
Rudy. I like everybody calling me Rudy. I really, you know why I like that? When they used to call me Rudy, I kind of knew they were going to vote for me.
Yeah, Rudy can't fail. Anyway, I've worked for many years as a bartender on the Upper West Side. And my question is, are you ever going to pay your cab? It's getting really high, dude.
Get out of here. Where are you a bartender?
The Kissing Cousin Bar over in Williams.
Oh, you're a... You guys got to come up with something funnier than that. Well, I have no debts to any bar.
The Worst of Us is a program where we basically invite the worst pieces of shit in the world on, and then we berate them for as long as they'll take it, and then they hang up. This week, we talked to a pastor from Tennessee who's trying to break people out of hospitals to get them treated with ivermectin. Yeah, check it out.
Is Tennessee have the highest infection rate?
From the numbers that I have heard lately, apparently it's in some of the tops in the numbers of the state. Yes, the states.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to The Worst of Us. I am Tommy Truth. I am joined by a very special guest today. He is a pastor in Tennessee. I believe the head of the Tennessee Pastors Network. And on top of that is also involved in the medical field. He has, right? I read that, right? You have some connection to the medical field, right? Like a...
No connection to the medical field. Just a pastor that obviously deals with a lot of families and a lot of pastors that are affected.
I see. I don't know. Why did I read? I read somewhere. I thought you were a medical professional as well. No.
No, sir.
Okay. But he's heavily involved in the anti-vaccine movement, the anti-medical tyranny movement. He uses his platform to discuss anti-vaccine, anti-mask information. He's actually gone so far now as to protest out in front of hospitals and medical facilities. Now, interestingly enough, the medical facilities, I believe the politicians who actually make the rules, they would not be at the medical facilities. They would be at a different building. So you're basically protesting a place where sick people who are dying are trying to get treatment from medical professionals, and your idea is to disrupt that. And I suppose you're also trying to break people out of hospitals in order for them to get a treatment that you deem to be appropriate. Again, you did mention off the top that you're not a medical professional. To me, it feels like you are somebody who perverts the word of God for profit. And so my first question for you, Dale, would be, go fuck yourself, you absolute fucking abomination. Yeah, Yeah. Figure out how to hang it up, you idiot. Figure out how to hang it up, old man.
Butch loves making calls, and he don't know much, but one thing he does know is that Jim Fetzer's a fucking piece of shit. That's right, the guy from The Worst of Us last week has his own show, and Butch called him and fucking torched him the way Butch only can. Check it out.
Well, he loves to talk, but he don't know much. He's your favorite caller, and his name is Butch.
Fauci, all the lemmings at the CDC, all the lemmings at the FDA, they are mass murdering people because they, you know, anyway, you get it.
We have another caller standing by from the 778 area code. Caller, please give us your name, just your first name and your state, and join the conversation.
Hey, it's Bud.
Hey, Butch.
Hello? Can you guys hear me? I said, Butch, I'm calling from Florida and Homestead of Florida and watching on video game website, watching your show on the politics and really enjoying it and trying to join the discussion.
Okay. Do you have a question for Dennis or Giuseppe or me?
Loves to talk, but he don't know much. He's your favorite caller, and his name is Butch.
Well, about in regards on the jab mandate, for the Giuseppe said in the jab you got a heavy metal, and is it in regards on music or what do you mean on that?
Heavy metals such as aluminum, thimerosal, which is a form of mercury, and other toxic, literal heavy metals, not heavy metal music.
I heard that the jab has ivermectin in it.
I've never heard that one. That's
They talk about it on shows I watch and a lot about vaccine. They say the ivermectin and for it to be on a vaccine. But I'm trying to follow on what you guys are saying and I really enjoy your show. And I'm basically exactly the type of viewer who was watching all the time. And Jim, are you feeling healthy yourself? You don't look so good on the screen. You look a little bit sick.
Really? No, I've been through it, and I took ivermectin, which I think helped. No, I'm feeling 90 to 95% back, so interesting observation.
You're like 90 to 95 years old.
I've never heard that before. Most people say...
Giuseppe looking like a normal and Jim Giuseppe, like very old.
Giuseppe, awesome. I'm baffled. I'm baffled by this caller. Baffled.
Yeah, he seems a little off.
We did our first video prank. Boy, did that change the game. Then we invited people on our own show. At the last second, changed the name. Me and the prank stars pranking while the fun bunch has some fun. Errol's Poop and Rudy got married, and somehow the shirt bit isn't done. Sometimes when I'm making calls, I have to wait on hold forever. Ask me if I trade it in. The answer is surely never. This was the best year of the show.
Thank you for watching.
All right, you go. Okay, I'll go. Hey everyone, thanks so much for watching. It really does mean a lot. Everyone, if you want to watch a little bit more, you can head over to patreon.com/noteven a show. A little bit of Patriot Pete and Daryl Kraft action over there. After that, we're gonna have the best of next week, and then October, it's vacation time. That means supercuts all of October. We're back November with NEAS Monthly.
Follow me over on Twitter at the CJS for more updates. Other than that, wow, what a fantastic year it was. And oh yeah, I was supposed to check in with Chris 3. Chris 3, did everything get all wrapped up for you and all the things that you had problems with are all solved now?
Yes, that is correct.
Fantastic. What a year. Bye, everyone. Say bye. Who cares? Bye.
Mike is a first-time caller out of Virginia. Mike, welcome to the show. You're on the air.
Hey, Jesse. Thanks for taking my call.
Yes, sir.
I just wanted to say what an incredible season it's been. We introduced video calls, which then evolved into the new fake show interviews. Daryl Kraft has become a big star. Rudy's with the cousin calls. We got him good.
Let me go to... I want to play this... Nick mentioned and Hank mentioned this guy that died, inspired. Let's see here. Oh, this guy, this is from Deadline. This guy was a comedian, Norm McDaniel.